The consistencies are incompatible.
Ready for another brush with destiny?
I'd rather mope around some more.
I'll be waiting.
Excuse me.
Yes?
Mr. President, may I offer you an excellent smoke?
Can you also provide me with a light?
Sure.
Well, in that case... Blast, I hate it when that happens. See if you can't find those for me, will you? There's a good lad.
Get me out of here! I haven't done anything.
Well, you must have done something or you wouldn't be here now, would you? You'd be out in the lobby with your tentacle owner, getting dressed up for the human show.
Owner? No one owns me.
Gosh, no owner, you say? Well, don't worry about it. I'm sure someone will come adopt you before we have to put you to sleep.
Damn that, Dr. Fred.
Hey, she knows the Edison family motto.
Yoo-hoo, Mr. Tentacle Guy.
What?
Ooh, I don't feel so good. I think I'm going to throw up all over.
Uh-oh. Time to visit Dr. Tentacle.
Well, well, what have we here?
I feel pukey.
Indeed. All right, now hold still.
Are you gonna use your scalpel?
No, of course not.
Darn. Do you want to use mine?
No.
What? What? What?
Just as I suspected.
What?
There's nothing wrong with you, human.
What a letdown.
Well, I'm late for the show. I'll send your keeper back for you. Oh, sit. Stay. Good boy.
Hey, how'd you get out? Get back in there. I wish Dr. Tentacle would stop losing patience.
Yoo-hoo, Mr. Tentacle Guy.
What?
I have to go to the bathroom.
Ha, that's a good one. Imagine a human using a bathroom. Come on, let's take a walk. Okay, human, do your business.
What was that? Let's see, it's 101-999-57. The legal language is pretty thick. I doubt if I could fix it.
Mr. Tentacle Guy.
It's about time.
Yoo-hoo, Mr. Tentacle Guy.
What?
Ooh, I don't feel so good.
Again?
Feel about humans?
Honestly, sir, I think they're filthy, obscene, foul, sickening, like the stuff in your eyes when you wake up, like the wax that builds up behind your suction cups after a few days, like...
That's enough, son. I just wanted to be sure you weren't one of those humanist sympathizers. What with this ridiculous human show going on here, there's humophiles everywhere.
I'm no humophile, sir.
That's good. Now, let me tell you about a little plan I have.
Hello, I'm a tentacle. I'd like to enter my insignificant human in the show.
Oh my, yes, yes, of course. Take these tags and put them on your human and have them wait on the bench in the lobby. Entrance will be judged in three categories: best smile, best hair, and best laugh.
Thank you, fellow tentacle. Unlike humans, you have been very useful.
Oh, thank you. Believe me, it was my pleasure.
Now all I need is a human.
Yowza! That was one good-looking tentacle.
Stupid tentacle. It's closed. Looks like there's some kind of rodent down there. You're ready to go now.
What are you babbling about?
You really should have told the judges if you weren't feeling well.
Oh, ick! Now, how did that mess get in there? I think I'm going to be sick.
Someone in here not feeling well?
I was feeling fine until I saw that.
Is that your regurgitation?
No, I'm an ICU man.
Didn't you just say you thought you were going to be sick?
That's just a figure of speech.
Do you realize you could have infected the whole show with human influenza?
But I just got all my shots.
You're a good-looking human, Harold, but you know the rules. You're out of the show.
What a mess. I hate cleaning up after humans.
Stop chattering, Mummy. The judges will think you're chewing gum. Oh, this will never work. I don't think that would look better white.
I said to her, that's not my suction cup.
Hey, when are you guys going to judge best hair?
Oh, all right.
Wow, that's the best hair I've ever seen on a mummy.
Thick and full.
And juicy.
The mummy wins.
Agreed.
When are you guys going to judge best smile?
Oh, all right.
I like the quiet one with the big teeth.
There's nothing in the rules about them being white.
First place goes to the mummy.
Agreed.
judge best laugh.
Oh, all right.
Okay, who's got a joke?
Hey, I just flew in from Baltimore, and boy are my suction cups tired.
A classic. It's amazing how the mummy can do that without moving his lips.
I say we give him first place.
Agree.
Well, that makes him best of show.
Let's go congratulate him.
He is very well preserved.
I'll miss his laugh.
It's time to give him his winnings and start packing up. We gotta get this whole show to Baltimore by Thursday.
Yes, our work here is done.
Well, Ted, this is where we part ways. You've certainly helped save humanity. Even though you've been dead for thousands of years, I think you're my favorite Edison. Hello, my silent gauze-wrapped friend. I really should go now. Call me sometime, okay?
I hope this isn't like the primitive, dangerous microwave ovens of my century. Those things could really pop a hamster good. Uh-oh. That was fun, but only because this is the 22nd century. You see, kids who put hamsters in microwaves back where I'm from get taken away from their parents and put up for adoption. So don't do it. I've already thawed him out. Besides, he won't let me insert the meat thermometer. A little teeny tiny sweater in there. Ooh, cute. This ought to warm him up.
I don't think I can put that in the chronogon.
It's a storage cabinet.
Say, cutie, what brings a hot tentacle babe like you to a dump like this?
I'm here by accident. Bye.
Hey, I don't want to be here either. Whoa! Dinner for two at Club Tentacle? I can't wait to tell my wife.
This ought to be good. Well, what do we have here? Looks like a prosthetic rodent. Another specimen. He's not even cooked.
Hey, look, a skunk.
Come back here, you mangy humans. You can't do this. This is an escape-proof facility.
Who says you can't learn anything from cartoons, eh, kitty? Look at that sucker go! He just keeps running and running and running.
Thank you.
Maybe we should add a rule that you can't dump sludge into the water supply.
What manner of fool would do that in the first place?
You're right.
Could you use these? Why, thank you, young man. Strange. I wonder if I should cut down on the coffee.
Hey, Tom, look! The father of our nation is cold. Better build a fire.
You're right.
Huh?
I guess you can have my log.
Me? Why should I build the fire? You build the fire.
I'm bothered by the smoke. You build the fire.
I'm bothered by your attitude. You build the fire.
No, you build the fire, Mr. Penmanship.
No, you build the fire, log lover.
No, you build the fire.
No, you build the fire.
You big baby.
Ah, excellent! I need that for my super battery. Ah, excellent! I need that for my super battery.
Okay, who was the idiot who started the fire? Excuse me?
Leave me alone. I'm too depressed to talk.
Wasn't Ben Franklin talking about... Hey, Founding Father. Not now, son. Can't you see we're in the middle of a crisis here? I wonder... Yo, Penmaster.
I'm afraid we're a little busy right now.
I bet this never happens to Tom Paine.
Thank you.
It looks pretty clear in here now. Say, did you get the pen on our way out?
No,
I found a blanket blocking the chimney.
Son, do you know anything about a blanket?
Didn't the dude next to you have one earlier? Hey, catch you later. I don't think I can forge Dr. Fred's signature.
Final element for my ingenious battery. Stand back, boy. Give me room to work. Of modern science. It will look lovely here on the shelf until I take it with me to Baltimore.
Don't look now, but the British are coming, dude.
Eh? Where? Is that supposed to be funny? I'm very busy.
Ready for another brush with destiny?
Sure, why not?
Splendid! Now!
Oops.
Look, it's very simple. I say now, and you push the kite. Comprenez-vous?
Got it.
Marvelous!
Oops.
Look, it's very simple. I say now, and you push the kite. Comprenez-vous?
Got it.
Marvelous! Now!
Whee!
He's handling kind of funny.
You got it. Just hang on there.
She's too heavy. I can't control her.
Hang on, Ben. Hang on.
She's breaking up. She's breaking up. Run for your life. Now that was interesting.
Yeah. Say, can I see that kite for a second?
No, I'm taking it back to my lab in Philly right now so I can study the results. Wish me luck. I never got your name.
It's Hoagie, sir.
Nice working with you, Hoagie. I promise to name an invention after you someday.
Gosh, thanks. Flush, my one chance of getting out of here? Yeah. Wow.
The legal language is pretty thick. I doubt if I could fix it. Not funny enough. I got the contract for you to sign, Doctor.
Sorry, I don't like to sign things that I haven't read.
Oh, forget it. I'll get rid of Purple Tentacle myself.
Oh, yeah? How?
I guess I can't. Hey, did you join a record club lately?
Good God, no! Those things are horrible, money-leeching death traps!
Well, there's a delivery man upstairs with a carton of easy listening 8-tracks for you. He says you have to pay for them.
Ah, not again!
Unless you sign this refusal form immediately.
Thanks! That was a close one. Well, good luck!
Yes, what do you want?
Hi there. Is this Dr. Fred Edison?
Who did you think you called? Dr. Spock? Look, I don't have all day.
This is Farley Crock at LucasArts Games. I just discovered your contract among some very old files, and, well, our lawyers say that we have to pay you $2 million in back royalties. For the use of your family in the Maniac Mansion video game.
What?
This is Farley Crock.
No, I heard that, you moron. When do I get my money?
Oh, right now. It's been credited to your Swiss bank account.
Operator, get me a travel agent. This is an emergency.